In this tutorial, we're going to look at what research data management means and why it matters. A lot of people have the impression that research data is a synonym for numbers or code and is only created by scientists running experiments in a lab. However, this isn't quite true. The University of Leeds has a great definition for us to consider. Research data is any information that has been collected, observed, generated, or created to validate original research findings. This means that researchers from every discipline can potentially generate research data, and their data will be in many formats in addition to numbers or code, including but not limited to algorithms or scripts, documents, field books or diaries, questionnaires, transcripts, audio or video files, artifacts, and/or application files, such as log files for analysis software. So now that we have a better idea of what is meant by research data, it's time to ask, why is it important? The answer is, research data is important because it's valuable. Conducting research takes considerable time, effort, and money, so it's important to manage your research outputs very carefully. You may be wondering, what do you mean by manage it? Research data management sounds like something really big and overwhelming, but mainly just comes down to basic planning and consistent record keeping. Well-managed data are organized and saved in a logical folder and file structure, are named using meaningful and consistent file naming practices that everyone on the team sticks to, such as using the same date format, are saved following a consistent version control plan, are labeled using meaningful column and row labels rather than obscure codes that no one outside the team would understand. Any codes that are used are documented in a codebook or README file that you'll keep alongside your data files. Don't worry about memorizing all of this now. We'll cover these record-keeping best practices in detail in the next tutorial. So, why is all this detail so important? Taking the time to manage your data makes it easier for team members to collaborate efficiently and accurately. Even if something as simple as agreeing to the same date format and file naming practices will reduce the likelihood of errors and confusion, you'll improve the likelihood that your data will be of long-term use both for your own team and other researchers through the years, which helps to justify the time, effort, and money spent on the project. It also ensures you won't waste valuable time at the end of your project trying to remember what now-forgotten abbreviations mean or to recapture accidentally deleted or improperly saved files. Carefully saving and storing your research data will also hugely decrease the likelihood of data loss or malicious data breaches. And last but definitely not least, your well-planned, organized, logically named, properly documented, safeguarded, saved data satisfies the many funder, journal, and/or institutional policies you may be subject to. In this video, we've learned that research data are generated in many different formats by researchers in many different disciplines. We've also learned that research data are valuable in their own right, and if carefully managed, will go a long way to justifying the time, effort, and money that went into completing the research project. In the next video, we'll take a closer look at best practices in data record keeping, particularly organizing, naming, and saving your data.